Happy New Year and welcome to T-Mobile Park. Please join me in welcoming the newest member of the Mariners organization, left-handed pitcher Yusei Kikuchi. Let me introduce the panelists first. Starting from the left to the right, we have Mariners manager Scott Servais, general manager Jerry Dipoto, Yusei in the middle, followed by his representative Scott Boras and Sean Novak on the end that will be interpreting for him. Welcome. Jerry, would you like to present Kikuchi with his jersey?
Absolutely.
We'll begin with a brief introduction from Jerry, followed by a comment by Yusei, and then we'll take questions in English, followed by questions in Japanese.
Welcome. Welcome, everybody, and particularly welcome Yusei Kikuchi. Yusei's family is here to join him today, and welcome to Seattle, everybody. This is an exciting thing for us. I shared with Scott Boras earlier today. We've done a lot of things in our time since we've been here in Seattle, trades, roster shifting and structuring, but this has been the most enjoyable because it was unexpected and a lot of fun. We get the chance today to add one of the premier pitchers in the world, a pitcher who has had a great deal of success in the NPB on the international stage, and now we are excited to bring him here to T-Mobile Park in Seattle, where we think the fit is just about as good as it could be with where we are in our organization's history and our developmental pattern. From an age, character, and talent standpoint, we don't think this fit could have been any better for us. And we are excited to introduce Yusei Kikuchi as the newest member of the Seattle Mariners. Welcome.
Hi, everyone. My name is Yusei Kikuchi of the Seattle Mariners. I'm very happy to be here. Today is a very special day for my family and I. Thank you for my family and amazing wife, Rumi, my friends, my high school coach, and my mentor, Mr. Sasaki, for supporting me every day. Playing in the big league has been a dream of mine since I was 15 years old. Thank you, Seattle Lions, for letting me go on and dream my dream. Mariners ownership and Mr. Dipoto and Mr. Servais, thank you for this new journey. And to my new teammates, I can't wait to meet you guys soon. Thank you.
That questions awesome. In English?
You say,
yes.
Why was Seattle a good fit for you? You had other choices. Why was this a good fit?
シアトルマリナーズはどうしてあの優勢にとっていいフィットだと思いますか。
I feel this team needed me the most, and I feel chemistry between us.
So you're doing this in English. I've heard you take great pride in how well you speak English. How important is it to you to be able to adapt to this new culture and speak English and fit in this way?
英語の勉強 あの前から取り組んであのしてると思うんですけど、それを聞いたんですけど、まあ、それも含めてアメリカになれるあのことはあの大事だと思ってますかって、どういうことをして取り組んであのなれますか。
I don't know detail yet, but I want to practice hard and adjust myself. And I want to enjoy every single thing.
You say, I wanted to just ask, you know, how did you get in the seat you are in today? What are probably the biggest challenges you feel like you overcome to get where you are now?
まあ、今座ってるあの舞台、あのここまで来るためいろいろ取り組んで、まあ、努力したと思うんですけど、まあ、自分にとって、まあ、どういう経験でどういうステップでここまで来れましたか。
I'm very excited and I'm very happy to be here and I thank the people who have supported me.
You said it was a dream of yours since you were 15 to play in the big leagues. What specifically are some of the things that you've done to prepare for the opportunity to play in a different experience like this?
15歳から、ね、メジャーに行く夢っておっしゃってましたけど、
And what was the reason after he's been wanting to play in the big leagues since 15?
What are some of the specific things he's done to prepare?
Got it. まあ、アメリカの野球になれるため、に準備してきたところ、まあ、その夢があって準備するところはどういうことを、まあ、考えたり努力してましたか。
I had a dream to play MLB when I was 15 years old. I have studied English really badly since then. And I already throw new baseball.
Yeah. The success of Ichiro and Kazuhiro Sasaki and Iwakuma play a factor in your decision to come to Seattle?
Seattle Mariners に決めるあの決断まで、あの Ichiro 選手、佐々木選手、Iwakuma 選手、まあ、過去の日本人選手が、マリナーズにいたっていうことを結構影響されましたか。
Yeah, of course. I want to continue the success
You say, have you met Ichiro? Do you have any sort of relationship with him?
Ichiro さんとの関係とか、まあ、お会いしたことありますか。
I haven't yet, but yeah, I hope today.
How big would it be to go back and pitch in Tokyo wearing a Mariners uniform when they start the season in Japan?
開幕戦が、今年日本で行われますけど、まあ初登板が、また日本で東京ドームで行われること、まあ、マリナーズ今回はユニフォームを背負って、ピッチングするかもしれないですけど、その気持ちについてはどう思いますか。
I hope that, but it is not my place to say.
As a rich history with his ties to Japanese players, how much of that was that part of the sell or how much did that come into the conversation, I guess, when you're talking to him? Certainly, everyone's well aware of what's happened here over the last 18 years or so in terms of Japanese players. But, how did that resonate with your newest guy here?
Well, you know, I think as you say referenced, it was certainly part of his calculus with the success we've had as an organization in developing Japanese stars. We've got a great history in that regard. The time that I spent working through this with Scott was...It was more about where Yusei ends up than where he begins. We know we're getting a very talented young player who's focused and high character. This is about step one in a development that will allow him to achieve his upside as a major league player, and we think it's considerable. And just like Kuma, just like Ichiro, just like Kaz Sasaki, we feel like this environment will be beneficial to him, and I think we all agree that this is a great fit from the city to the ballpark to our division and hopefully to our people because we have a good connection here.
We talked with you at the winter meetings. The process hadn't even really started. Can you describe how it kind of worked from there on to get to where you are today?
Well, I guess first we're thankful for how adjustable Yusei and Scott have been throughout this whole process.As you are now aware, it's a fairly unique contract. And, you know, if nothing over the many decades in the game, Scott's been very creative in the way he's set up some contractual agreements with clubs, and we were able to draft off some of that and create what I think is an agreement that makes sense for the Seattle Mariners, for Yusei Kikuchi, that makes sense in context of the league around us. And, you know, we made that first call to Scott to express our interest, and it took off quickly from there. Spent a lot of the last month working through basic understandings of how the contract would be structured, and then over the last week or 10 days, finer detail, and then started getting excited about the possibility that this was actually going to happen, which it did.
You described the contract and why it fits best. It's very different with the posting process now compared to what it was. I mean, how important was this?
I think it's very, you know, instructive. Of course, Jerry being a major league pitcher and Scott being a major league catcher is very helpful to, and I think working with their ownership to sit down and talk about what, you know, YK's needs were coming in, because that was very important to us. There's been a history of Japanese pitchers who were very, very gifted coming here and being thrust into a situation where the physicality, not the talent of the pitcher, but the physicality and durability of the pitcher have been challenged, and often has led to, you know, surgery. And Jerry was just completely open to our concern, mindful of it, sat down and came back to me with a developmental plan that was very impressive and very something that would lead to a certainly an acclimation to the major leagues on the part of YK, but also something that provides for a better approach, adjusting from the 6-day, 7-day approach in Japan to the 5-day approach here. And it certainly led us to understand that we could structure a contract that would allow at inception certain guarantees, but would also allow for the Mariners to be rewarded for a developmental process they instituted originally, and that can grow in having the benefits of YK's durability as we go forward. So all those concepts were worked together in something that allows for an inception appraisal and also a reward for working together to create a very, very durable and kind of a finishing of what skill we know YK has to allow him to be great in the major leagues for a long time.
Give a deal is this compared to some of the others that you helped negotiate with Jusega?
Well, you know, the part is that clubs, when you're using a major league roster spot and you're using a piece of your rotation, you have to have a community approach, if you will, with your bullpen and with the other starters and everyone involved to really put something like this together. And that flexibility is something that's challenging for a general manager and ownership and a community. And what we wanted to be assured of, that the talent and the commitment that, you know, this is an extraordinary young man. I have never had a press conference with a Japanese player where he's come here on his own and presented himself to the city of Seattle and done so in perfect English. And all of us who are language challenged and have played in different countries and done things, we know how difficult that is. And it says a lot about his learning aptitude, about his commitment, about what he wants to do, at what level in the major leagues, and to have a club that really understood him and their scouting, and we credit Jerry's scouting staff that they understood YK and his needs. And they also understood that in our representation of him, that we felt there needed to be an adjustment as to how we treat the acclimation of the Japanese pitcher to the major leagues. And certainly that unique thinking on the Mariners' part was something we wanted to reward, and we wanted to make sure that they got the benefit of the developmental process to assure YK's well-being as he acclimated himself to the big leagues.
Can you elaborate on this plan?
Sure. Yeah.
I know you're waiting to do it.
I'm an elaborator. Yeah. I fully agree with what Scott just said about the acclimation of the pitchers from the MPB as they come here to MLB. You get a lot of that 2-year burst, and then there's a drawback because we have not developed innings the appropriate way. So much like we've done in development, we've talked about the possibility of controlling innings through creative, start times. We don't want to disrupt a 30-start season. We think going from opening day through the end of the season and taking 30 starts without downtime is critical to understanding a major league season. But along the way, we can create, or lessen the inning burden by every fifth or sixth start, just making it a short start where there is a one-inning, 30-pitch type outing. We do it with our prospects at the minor league level as we're trying to acclimate them to the long minor league season. And we think this is a great opportunity for 2019 to do something similarly here, especially with YK, with guys like Justice Sheffield and Eric Swanson and potentially Justin Dunn starting to move toward the major league level, is using the innings that exist in a major league season in a more community-oriented way and ensuring that YK makes his starts and goes from end to end. And we're not necessarily looking for complete games every night. We want to use 2019 to develop the innings in a more appropriate and health-oriented fashion.
Jerry, do you think that process is a one-year process of acclimation, or can it carry into the second year?
If there's anything I've learned in 3 decades in Major League Baseball, you adjust. You lay out a game plan and you adjust as you go. And YK will let us know when that process is done. And what we may find out is that kind of inning, absorbing innings as a staff, may just be the future of baseball. We've talked about it in many ways before over these last 3 years, is how you distribute your innings amongst the staff has changed a lot. Just in the day when I first got in baseball, there were guys throwing 300 innings. That's not smart as it pertains to long-term pitcher health. And our priorities here are winning games, putting ourselves in a championship position, and doing it with the health and well-being of the players in mind. And we'll continue to operate that way and adjust as needed.
Scott, how do you implement this?
You'll be very disciplined. There's no question about it. And that's organizational decisions as you go through, putting a rotation together. But understanding where Yusei is in his development is huge. I'm really excited to have him on board. I'm actually a little nervous when I get to Japan. My Japanese is not going to be near as good as what he did today. But having an opportunity to spend some time with him, seeing where he's at, watching a lot of video, and how I think he'll acclimate to our team and to the Major League game, I'm really, really excited. But it takes some discipline to make sure that we all stay on the same page, because as a manager, when they get going good, you want to keep running them out there every fifth day. And that's not what the plan is here. I think the plan is that it's a long-term play, and want to get the most out of YK. I like that, Scott. I'm going to go with YK. That's a good fit. But I am excited about it.
For people who have never seen you pitch, could you describe how you pitch?
Yusei のプレーをまだ見たことない人たちに自分のピッチングスタイルのことを少し話してください。
My strong point is fastball and slider. Yes.
How much do you try to move maybe some of your pitching mechanics in your game after some of the other pitchers you can, or even from here, who might have been very close to get to where you are now?
Yusei 選手の、ピッチングスタイル、フォームとか球種とか、ちっちゃい時から今まで、メジャーの選手なのか日本の選手の真似したりどこかを取り組んで作り上げているのか、そういう選手はいますか？
It is very hard to explain in English. Can I speak Japanese? Yeah. でも昔から メジャーリーグの試合を小さい頃から見てましたので、メジャーの選手のフォームだったり球種だったり、日本人選手の、フォームだったり、そういうのを真似しながら、プレーしてました。
He's watched Big League Baseball since he was pretty young, I'm going to say about 14 or 15, and he's, you know, took that as a sample, an example for pitching mechanics, different types of pitches to throw, but also he's watched a lot of Japanese baseball, so he's picking shows from Japanese pitchers as well.
So we know Ohtani went to the same school. How well do you know him? How exciting to be in the same division and play against him?
Hello.
I think he has a big talent, and I'm looking forward to challenging him many times.
I figured just ask if you asked at all about whether you could pick up a bat every now and then too. Should I, or are you pretty comfortable just content being on the mound?
ユセもたまにバッティングをバッターボックス入りたいですか、もしくはもうピッチングだけで大丈夫ですか。
Focus on my pitching.
大谷選手と アメリカに来る、ことは話したことありますか。
I haven't discussed that with him.
Jerry, in terms of going back to the idea of the developmental plan, does this change a little bit now what you're looking for moving forward? Because Scott's going to be presented with some challenges now. Maybe you look for more swing guys, things that can make, in layman's terms, Scott's job easier in terms of managing the roster from day to day, just because of this plan that we're implementing.
Yeah, if you look at our roster today, that's effectively with YK, with Mike Leake, Marco, Felix, Wade LeBlanc, Roenis Elias, and then what we think is a wave of players that are coming, led by Justice Sheffield and Eric Swanson, I guess being next in line or next closest. We're excited by that group, and we feel like we can implement over the course of a 1,500-ish inning season, there's plenty to be moved around, and we don't have a back end of the bullpen right now that is set in stone in terms of one inning per outing type relievers. We can be creative in how we get there, and my job is to figure out a way to make Scott's job easier, and I know I don't do that very often, but I'm going to try to do it a little better, and if we have players that are as talented as this, we'll figure out a way to make it all work.
Scott, will he be, how much is he in the competition to pitch in Tokyo?
He's in the competition to pitch in Tokyo.
I'm anxious to get to spring training, see him pitch, see how he assimilates to our ball club, and go from there. But why wouldn't he? We'll see what happens.
Any other questions in English?
One more. You say, what did you know about the city of Seattle before coming here, and what have you seen in the last few days when you finalized this deal?
Seattle に来る前、Seattle 自体のこと何か知ってましたか、勉強しましたかと、あとついてからの印象を教えてください。
I watched the Wikipedia and I hear there are enthusiastic fans here in Seattle. And it is a beautiful city.
Questions in Japanese?
日本語での質問ございますか。
はい、佐々木監督と、はい、両親に今の気持ちをどのようにお伝えしたいですか。
The question is, what kind of comments or emotions do you have? An emotional comment for his high school coach and to his parents.
まず佐々木監督に対しては本当に、高校1年生の時に、目標設定をする時に、呼ばれて高卒で、高卒でというかメジャーを一緒に目指そうという話を、していただいたのを覚えています。
The first thing he remembers of his high school coach, Coach Sasaki, is that his freshman year, his first year in high school, he took him aside and they said, let's develop you and let's get you ready to play in the big league someday. That's the most impactful and the biggest memory he has of Mr. Sasaki.
それが15歳の時で、それから12年、結果が出ない時もいつも、プロに入ってからも連絡したりとか会いに行ったりとかして、励ましてもらって、やっとその12年前の夢が叶って本当に、嬉しく思います。
That conversation he has was when he was 15, and for the next 12 years after he graduated and became pro, he's always consulted and talked to Mr. Sasaki through the up and downs, and now he's finally here 12 years later, and he'd like to tell him thank you for always having my back.
家族に対しては本当に、小さい頃から、野球を自由にさせてもらって、そして、小学校の時にプロ野球選手になるという夢を言ってから、いろんな思いもさせてしまったと思うんですけど、こうやってここの舞台に立てて本当に、嬉しく思います。
And a big thank you to my parents. You know, I always said I wanted to play professional baseball since I was in elementary school, and you know, they took a lot of time off their schedule to take me to practice and games, and I may have made it difficult for them at times, but they've always supported me and let me live my dream, and I'm here now as well, so I'd like to say thank you to my parents as well.
背番号18を選んだ理由、はい、そしてどんな思いがその番号に持っているんですか。
You chose number 18. Can you share your feelings and thoughts on why you chose number 18?
18について
。18番。
はい。やはり18番というのは日本人選手にとって特別な番号だと思っています。過去歴代日本でもメジャーリーグでもたくさんの偉大な投手がつけてきた番号をいつか背負いたいなと思ってましたので、18番を選ばせていただきました。
Number 18 is a very special number for pitchers in Japan. And there's been a lot of great pitchers in Japan and the States, the Japanese players that have worn number 18. And he felt that he wanted to wear that number one day and follow in their footsteps. And he was able to pick that number here. And he hopes to succeed and keep up with those successful pitchers.
18番つけてたのが岩隈選手というのをご存じだと思うんですけども、2017年二段モーションのことが言われているときに、
はい、
おそらく間接的に確かメッセージを受け取ったはずなんですけれども、はい、あの時のメッセージというのは菊池選手にどういう意味を持ったんでしょうか。
岩隈さんからのメッセージ。
そうですか。
The last pitcher or last player here to wear number 18 was Iwakuma, Hirosashi Iwakuma. In 2017, Yusei had a double type motion that he was warned about, that he had to change. And Iwakuma has sent him a message encouraging him, and they'd like to know his thoughts on that message and if that helped him out in 2017.
はい。僕自身もすごく去年の二段モーションというのは、すごく悩みました。そこでたくさんの OB や先輩方にいろんな話を聞いたんですけれども、その中でも本当に岩隈さんのアドバイスというのは心に残ってます。
You know, it was a tough spot when they told me to change my mechanics. Obviously, I struggled kind of mentally as well. And a lot of alumni players, other pitchers, and consultants kind of gave me advice, and one of them was obviously Iwakuma-san, and his advice I took to heart, and I think it helped me out.
去年初めて直接お会いした時に、そのお礼も言わせていただきました。
Last year I met him for the first time briefly, and I said thank you for the message. It really helped me out.
物心ついた時から、黒選手は黒だったと思うんですが、その黒選手と同じフィールドで練習して。
Obviously, I think, you know, Ichiro Suzuki is a big influence to a lot of Japanese players. What are your thoughts about being able to practice and play with him this year?
まあ簡単には説明できないというか、特別な思いはあります。
It's not an easy feeling to explain, but he's looking, you know, very excited for it.
僕が初めてプロ野球を見に行った時に、イチローさんが最後の日本でのプレーした年で、岩手県野球場というところで、オリックス戦を見に行ったのを今でも鮮明に覚えていて、
He distinctly remembers the first professional baseball game went to Japan was Ichiro's last season. They played at a public stadium in Iwate when he was with the Oryx, Buffalo, Oryx Blue Wave at the time. And he remembers that, that game very well.
そこで僕は野球を始めたばかりだったので、本当イチローさんのことしか知らないような状態で球場に行ったんですけれども。
That's the first time he started playing baseball.And he went there only kind of knowing of Ichiro. So it was a big moment, and he was very anxious to watch him play in person.
その時のこう、なんだろうな、もうオーラというか、雰囲気というか、そういうのはもう、自分の昔の記憶なんですけど、ずっと記憶に残ってます。
I mean, it was a while back, but he could still remember the aura that Ichiro had.On the field and just how exciting it was for him to for Yusei to watch Ichiro play in person.
まあそれからイチローさんの本はほとんど、読んできましたし、イチローさんのことを考えとか、ルーティンとかを知りたいと思って特集や本は、ほとんど読んできたつもりです。
And since then, he's read any book there is about Mr. Ichiro, any articles about Mr. Ichiro, about his play style, his work ethic. It's something that he's studied, and he's really looking forward to be able to speak in with him.
なので本当に会う機会があると思うので、たくさんお聞きしたいこともありますし、一緒にプレーさせていただけるのが楽しみで仕方ないです。
It's really hitting him now that he's going to be able to finally meet him. So he's very excited. He has a lot of questions he wants to ask him, and he hopes to learn a lot from Mr. Ichiro.
どういう選手たちが自分の心をメジャーに行かせてくれたと思いますか
In 2015, or I'm sorry, when his first year of high school, you know, his coach told him, let's go to play in the big leagues together, let's get you there. And obviously, Mr. Ichiro was an influence for you. Are there any other players that influenced you toward your dream to playing in the big leagues?
Ichiro さんはじめたくさんの日本人選手が世界の舞台で活躍するのを見て、まあ、それは野球に限らずいろんなスポーツで日本人選手が活躍するのを見て、やはり僕も、日本人でも努力をしっかりして、積み重ねていければいつか日本人でも世界の舞台で活躍できるという夢をいただいたので、その影響はすごく大きかったです。
Obviously, Mr. Ichiro was a big influence, as well as all the other Japanese players that have played in the big leagues. But even bigger than that, he's really respected all the Japanese athletes that have gone on to play internationally, and that's helped him work hard. It's given him motivation to want to be another representative of Japan to play in the big stage, and he's going to work hard to be successful and be in that group as well.
まあ、今年のプレーが新しい場所で始まるわけですけども、今その新しい場所でプレーすることにおいて、ご自身で一番まあ大事にしていること、こうやっていこうと思っているようなこと、そういうのをお願いします。
It's a new city, obviously a new league that you're going to be playing in. What is it that you think is going to be most important to you and that, that you need to work on?
そうですね。まず日本で積み上げてきたものというものを、評価していただいて、この場にいられると思いますので、まずは自分の持っているものをしっかり今まで出してきたものをしっかり出せるように、まずそこがまず一番。
The first thing, you know, he's been evaluated and scouted and valued for what he's done in Japan, so he does not want to stray away from that. He wants to keep improving on what he's built in his career over there. That's the most important thing so far.
まあその中で対戦していく、まあオープン戦だったりとか。 キャンプ中にいろんなことが気づくと思いますし、変えていかなきゃいけないところも出てくると思いますので、そこにうまく早く、アジャストするっていうのが、ここの舞台で、結果を出す上で大切になるのかなと思います。
Also thinks that, you know, while staying to his roots, he's going to learn a lot during spring training, exhibition games, and he wants to be able to adjust quickly there, work with the staff, and make those adjustments as quickly as possible to better succeed for the regular season.
イチローさんと一緒のフィールドに立つ、プレーする、投げるっていうイメージは今はどのようにお考えですか？
How do you feel about possibly playing with Mr. Ichiro in Tokyo for the opening series?
そうですね。まず最初にイチローさんが本当に雲の上の存在すぎて会うまでちょっと信じられないっていうのが正直なところです。
I mean, first things is that, you know, Mr. Ichiro is kind of a person in the sky, a legend. So, you know, he doesn't know if he even really exists. And the first step is to be able to meet with him and talk to him first.
その上で、本当にもし、一緒にプレーする機会があれば、必ず、僕の一生の財産になると思いますし、そのピッチングっていうのを楽しみたいなと思ってます。
And when I do have the opportunity to step on the field with him, you know, it's going to be a great memory for me that I'll cherish forever, and I really look forward to that moment.
メジャーリーガーになるという夢を叶えた今、どんな新たな夢を今持ってますか？
Now that you've, you know, are able to be a major leaguer, you've signed the contract, what is the next goal or the next dream that you have?
いや本当にまず僕自身は、9年間日本でプレーしましたけれども、順調に、全てのことがうまくいったわけではなく怪我もありましたしいろんな壁にぶち当たったこともあるんですけれども、
First things, you know, he's had some ups and downs in Japan for the last 9 years, but he's happy at how he's able to develop in the latter parts and to get here at this stage so far.
でもその中で日本のファンの方々に、いい時も悪い時もですね、結果が出ない時も、応援していただいて、その本当に感謝の気持ちが今一番強いなというのが正直なところです。
The Japanese fans really pushed for him and had his back through the ups and downs through the 9 years, and he's very grateful and thankful for that support.And he hopes to be able to succeed and live up to their expectations over here. And he hopes that they'll continue to support him in Seattle.
まだまだその技術的にも人間的にも、成長しなきゃいけないところっていうのはたくさんありますので、アメリカでプレーする中で技術的にも精神的にも人間的にも大きくなるところをまず。日本の皆さんに見せられるようにというのが一番です。
He'd like to show the Japanese fan and the people another stage of development from his time here, mentally, physically on the field. He'd like to have them watch him grow with the team and succeed. And he wants to tell the fans thank you and please continue the support.
はい、まあその中で、具体的な目標というのはまだないんですけれども。こっちに来ることが目標ではなく結果を出すことが目標だというのは、前提として必ず自分の胸にあります。
He has no specific goal at this time. You know, getting here was not the goal. It's to succeed here and play well here. So he's just going to focus on the starts every day and working hard and being able to produce for the team.
今日自己紹介だけじゃなく、まあ、英語での質疑応答も全部英語でしたというのはどういう思いなんですか？
What are your thoughts and feelings on not only doing your speech in English, but also answering the Q&A in English?
そうですね。聞き苦しい、下手くそな英語でまず申し訳なかったっていうのがまず一番言いたい。
So I want to apologize to the English media of my bad English, short answers, and thank you for bearing with me.
ただ、こうやって世界最高峰の 舞台でプレーする中でやはりたくさん、文化の違いだったり、環境の違いだったりそして考え方の違いだったり超一流の選手たちとプレーをするので
Being here on the biggest stage of baseball in the world、you know, it's a global stage and I wanted to、ingrain myself with that and be available to everyone and to speak directly with everyone so I worked hard and that was an important thing for me to go、do going forward、
せっかくならば自分の英語でいつか、そういう世界一の舞台のに立っている選手たちと英語で話をしてみたいという思いは、高校時代からずっと持ってましたんで少しずつ勉強してきたつもりです。
And from high school when he had the goal and dream of playing in the big leagues, he wanted to be able to communicate directly from the heart to the fans over here in English by himself. So he worked hard and made that a goal also to learn English and to be able to speak it for the time that he got here where he is today.
Final question.
今日締めてらっしゃるネクタイはマリナーズを意識したものだと思うんですけれども、こちらに来てご自身とか、まあ、奥様と選ばれたのか、まあ、自分の気持ちがマリナーズに決まった時に、まあ、LA で選ばれたのか、まあ、その子の思いを教えてください。
I see that you're wearing a Seattle Mariners colored necktie. Wanted to know if you were kind of prepared for joining the team while your time was in LA or kind of when you got here.
昨日この色のネクタイを探しに行ったら僕の目の前に飛び込んできたのがこれでした。
When I went shopping yesterday to look for a tie, this is the first thing that I saw and I grabbed it right away.
まあなんかこうケミストリーがあったのかと思います。
I felt like that was another kind of a chemistry it was meant to be that the first I saw was the exact colors of the Mariners, so he knows he's in the right spot.